Welcome back on Info for Tripling, and you are watching a series on basics of MATLAB Simulink, and this is 20th lecture of this series in which we will discuss about relational operator in MATLAB Simulink, and you are with Paramjit Singh Jamwal. First of all, we will discuss why to use relational operator. One of the important use of this block is as pulse width modulation controller. This PWM controller generates switching sequence as output on the basis of sawtooth wave and error signal as input. In this figure, sawtooth wave is shown with green color and sinusoidal error signal is shown with red color. When amplitude of this error is greater than the amplitude of sawtooth wave, it generates one value, and when amplitude of this error is less than amplitude of sawtooth wave, it generates zero value. With this logic, it generates this switching sequence, and it is clearly visible that in this period error is more, hence on time is more, and in this period error is less, hence on time is less. This logic is also given in mathematical form here. You can find PWM controller application for PMS and drive in this paper. Now moving towards the practical session. In this session, we will continue the simulation we have created in 19th lecture. So just open it and save it with different name. Now click on repeating sequence block to update its parameter. Update time value to 0.01 second and output value to -1 to 1 and close it. This block will generate our sawtooth wave. Now open simulation we have created in second lecture. Now copy this block from here and paste it in our simulation file. Now open this block to change its parameter. We need to change only amplitude to 0.85 and close it. This block will generate our sinusoidal error of amplitude 0.85. Now open Simulink library and drag mux block to your simulation file to mux the error and sawtooth wave together. So just disconnect this connection and mux sawtooth wave and sinusoidal error together and connect at first terminal of scope. Now delete this relay block from here. Now go to Simulink library browser and go to logic and bit operation and identify relation operator block. It is available here. Just drag it into your simulation file. Now connect first input with sawtooth input and second input to the sinusoidal error and connect its output to the scope output. Now just rearrange it for simplicity. Now our simulation is ready. Now run this simulation for 0.2 seconds. Now you can clearly see here our desired sawtooth wave and error signal is generated here, and switching sequence is generated here. This is sufficient for today. If you find this video useful, then like and share it. Have any query, just leave it in below mentioned comment box. Subscribe our channel and click on bell icons to get the notification about our upcoming videos. Thank you for being with us.